Less widespread, but grabbing lots of headlines, are carp from Asia. Specifically, the bighead and silver carp species, which pose a significant threat to Minnesota waters. Individual bighead carp and DNA from silver carp have been found in the St. Croix River and in the Twin Cities portion of the Mississippi River, indicating some fish are here.
The primary threat that Asian carp, both bighead and silver carp, pose is the fact that they can short-circuit the food chain. They're very efficient filter feeders. They take the phytoplankton and the zooplankton that all of our native fishes, from shiners to bluegills to walleyes to paddlefish, need for their basic survival. And they're just extremely good at this, and that way they can really outcompete our native species.
Originally stocked in aquaculture ponds in the south to control algae, floods allowed them to escape into the Mississippi River drainage and move upstream. They are prolific breeders, capable of virtually taking over entire stretches of river, altering the local fish community dramatically. While bighead carp eat more and grow larger, it's the high-flying silver carp that offer vivid evidence of the invasion. Approaching boats can scare entire schools of silver carp into leaping out of the water, causing serious injuries when they hit boaters and personal watercraft users. Some boaters are forced to wear protective helmets, hide behind windshields, or avoid boating on infested rivers. Round gobies are another unwelcome guest in America, courtesy of European ballast water discharged into the Great Lakes. They have no swim bladder and live their entire life cycles within a few inches of the bottom. In some areas of the Great Lakes, they have become the preferred forage of smallmouth bass, but due to their sheer numbers, there are more than enough gobies present to withstand bass predation. Young gobies devour a combination of insects, fish eggs, and whatever they can get. Because they have ferocious appetites, gobies can quickly gobble up the eggs in the unguarded nests of bass or panfish. European ruff are another European transplant that has moved into the St. Louis estuary at Duluth. Like gobies, they are unchecked predators that compete with native species like yellow perch. Minnesota's waters also have been invaded by common carp, sea lamprey, and white perch, all of which stress native species. Eurasian water milfoil is one of the plant invaders which has become a nuisance in many Minnesota waters. The introduction of Eurasian milfoil to America can be traced to the aquarium trade, where plants were imported for use in fish tanks but ended up in local waters. Eurasian milfoil is an aggressive rooted plant that quickly grows to the surface. It spreads out across the water surface, forming an umbrella-like canopy that blocks sunlight and chokes out the native plants below. Milfoil forms dense, unsightly cover through which it's difficult to swim or navigate. Small pieces of milfoil carried on boats and recreational gear can seed a new invasion if they are carried to other lakes. Numerous attempts have been made to eradicate Eurasian milfoil and other invasive aquatic plants from lakes, mostly by chemical treatments or pulling, but these efforts have not succeeded in completely eliminating the plants. The reality that eradication is not usually possible means preventing it from spreading is a top priority.
I grew up out here on Minnetonka since the early 70s. 1987, milfoil was found on the lake and grows in about 5 to 15 feet of water. In that 5 or 15 feet of water is typically matted. We've got a 14,000 acre lake here, and of the lake, about 6,000 acres of it is that 5 to 15 feet of water depth. Before we had milfoil, before the 1987, the lake was completely usable as far as an acreage standpoint. You didn't notice it. It was one of the cleaner lakes that was out there. Since then, it's everywhere, 5 to 15 feet of water depth. That's areas where we swim, fish, water skis, race sailboats, all those different things. And with it being matted there, that's completely impacted or changed the way we've used the lake or the way I grew up knowing the lake. We can't use those areas for that type of stuff.
Also present in Minnesota are unwanted populations of curly leaf pondweed, flowering rush, and purple loosestrife.